Good morning to all. So today we are going to start our next lesson, that is lesson 16, plant and animal hormones. Okay, so we have completed the reproduction in plants in the previous classes. So just once reading the book, okay, and also the marked questions you may study. The next one we are going to study about lesson 16, plant and animal hormones. So what are hormones? That is, it's a chemical substance that which means to excite. Okay, hormones, the meaning is to excite. Hormone, the meaning is to excite. Okay, so what is the use of this, where is it produced? And we are in this chapter, we are going to study about plants and animals. Both plants and animals are able to produce the hormones. And in this chapter, we are going to study about both of them, both plant hormones and animal hormones, where it is produced and what is the function, what is the use of these hormones, we are going to study about. Okay, hormones, the meaning is to excite. So in plants, it is controlling the coordination and the physiological functioning of the plant is controlled by the hormones, by the chemical substance. Hormone is a chemical substance that is controlling the functions, physiological function and coordination of the plants. Okay. Hormones. It's a chemical, but that is functioning of the plant, that is physiological and the controlling or coordination of plants is controlled by a chemical substance, and that is said to be hormones. Okay, it is a chemical substance. Hormones are chemical substance. Okay, chemical substance that is controlling and coordinating the function of the control and coordinate the function of a plant. That's also said to be hormones. Once again, it's a hormones or that is it's a chemical substance which are produced by the plants, and it is controlling and coordinating the functions of a plant. Then this hormones, where is it produced in plants? It is produced in each and every cell of the plant body. Okay, the hormones are produced on each and every cell of the plant body. Then coming to the function, that is coming to the animal hormones is a chemical substance. Hormones, that is endocrine glands, are responsible for the production of hormones. Endocrine glands, which are present in our body, that are located in several parts of the body, are controlling the that is physiological activity, that it is development, growth, reproduction, metabolism, etc. All these are controlled by the hormones, which are produced in separate glands which are present in our body. Okay, that is endocrine glands. That also to be endocrine glands, and endocrine glands are producing the chemical substances. By the chemical coordination, we are performing the different functions of the body, and these chemicals are said to be hormones. Hormones are produced where? In the endocrine glands. In human beings or animals, we can say that there is hormones are produced by the endocrine glands. Endocrine glands in animals. Okay, this is about plants. Plants, it is produced in different cells or the cells of the body, cells of the plant body. Here the endocrine glands are producing the hormones, that is performing the different functions. It is traveled from the place of secretion to the place of action through the blood. Okay, that we can come later. First we are going to study about the plant hormones. Okay, first we are going to study about plant hormones. What are the different plant hormones which are produced and their function and their physiological effect in the plants? First one, that is chemical substances. Plant hormones, these are chemical substances that are produced in very low concentration in the plants. Okay, it is produced in very low concentration, not very high, very small amount of hormones is enough for the physiological activities of the
plants. Okay, so the hormones or chemical substances, there are plant hormones or chemical substances that are produced in very low concentration. Low concentration, and so that so low concentration is enough for the functioning of the plants. So let us see what are the plant hormones, types of plant hormones which are present in plants. Okay, first one, auxin. There are five types of them, five hormones are there which are produced by the plants. Five hormones. First one, it is auxin. Second one, cytokinin. Third one, gibberellins. Fourth one, abscisic acid. And finally, last one is ethylene. So these are the different plant hormones present in plant. Once again, what are they? Auxin, cytokinin, gibberellins, abscisic acid and ethylene. These are the different plant hormones. Among these, first three, that is auxin, cytokinins and gibberellins, are growth promoters. Okay, they will promote the different activities of the plant. Okay, growth promoters. Promoters, and these two are growth inhibitors. So these are about the types. Okay, auxin, cytokinin, gibberellins, abscisic acid and ethylene. Among this, first three are said to be growth promoters and next two are said to be the growth inhibitors. That is, this will promote means, that is, foster, induces the different functions, and that is positive effect on plants. Okay, these are providing the positive effect on plant, and these two are giving negative effect, that is, inhibiting the growth, prohibiting the different activities of the plants. Okay, so this is about the types. So each and every type we are going to study about. Okay, first one, auxins. First one we are going to study about auxin. Okay, auxin was introduced by Cole and Hannah Smith. Okay, these are the two persons who have put forth, and that is, coined the term auxin. Okay, first, that is Charles Darwin. This is a chemical, that is plant hormone, which is present at the tip of the plant. So mostly it is present in both root tip and shoot tip. So auxin, it was first discovered, that is, first Charles Darwin, he has found out that some substances is present at the tip of the plant. Okay, tip of the plant, that is facilitating the growth of the plant. The typical growth, apical growth or apex of the plant growth, that is, this will be the apex. Okay, this auxin, that is, some substance is present at the tip of the plant that is helping in the growth of the plant, was first found out by Charles Darwin. But he hasn't found out what is the substance here which is produced by the plants. Okay, so Charles Darwin was the person who has found out that some influence is there on the tip of the plant that is helping in growth, that is longitudinal growth of the plant. So later F.W. Wett, the person called F.W. Wett, was the person who has named it as, that is, the substance that is influencing the growth of the plant is auxin. He has found out that F.W. Wett. Okay. F.W. Bench was the person who has termed that chemical substance that is produced at the tip of the plant as auxins. Okay. So by he has conducted an experiment in the Avena polyptera. Avena means oats plant. Okay, oats plant. He has polyptera. The tip of the shoot tip is known as polyptera. Okay, he has conducted an experiment in the shoot tip of Avena plant. Avena polyptera. Polyptera means that is shoot tip of the plant. Okay, shoot tip of the plant is said to be polyptera. Shoot tip is said to be polyptera. He has conducted an experiment in Avena plant. That is polyptera of the Avena plant. And he has found out that a chemical substance which is produced at the tip of the plant is in, responsible for the growth of the plant. For this experiment, he has selected the plant, and what he has done, the first experiment, he has cut the polyptera tip. Okay, so this is the first experiment. He has cut the polyptera tip and allowed the plant to grow. After a few days, he has found out that there is no growth is happening in this plant. Okay, the first plant, first experiment, he has now concluded that without the tip of the growing tip, the plant is not able to grow. The next experiment, what he has done is he has removed the polyptera tip and he has kept an agar block. Agar block means it is a substance which is will be in the form of a block, and it consists of growth promoting substance which is formed from seaweed, agar-agar. Okay, agar-agar, this is seaweed. It is obtained from the marine, algae. Okay, algae is a seaweed. That agar is, agar block consists of this growing substance, and he kept the agar block above the tip of the polyptera. He has removed the, in the second experiment, he has removed, again he has removed the polyptera tip and kept an agar block over the tip region. So what he has observed is, again the plant is not able to grow in this condition also. So next he has done, he has again removed the tip of the plant, that is growing tip was removed, and he kept the growing tip above the surface of the agar block. Okay, that's the third experiment. Third experiment, he has removed the polyptera tip and he has placed the tip over the agar block. So here what happened, after some days he has again removed the tip from the block and placed the agar block above the surface of the polyptera. After removing the, so what he has done once again is that he has removed the tip of the polyptera and he placed it above the agar block. After 1 or 2 hours, he has removed the tip region, and only the block he has kept over this polyptera, that is growing tip of this plant, removed pot. Okay, then what happened to this experiment? The plant started to grow. Okay, in this condition, the plant started to grow. Okay. So from this he has concluded that he has placed the growing tip, polyptera tip, over this block, isn't it? At that time, some substance has been passed on to the agar block. Okay, so that's how he concluded that some substance is released from the tip of the plant, and that is responsible for the growth of this plant. Okay, so from this experiment, he has concluded that the growing substance is present at the tip of the, that is apical tip of root and shoot. So, and it was named as auxin. Okay. So, once again, listen, he has, F.W. Welch, he has done an experiment to prove that auxins are responsible for the, the chemical substance is produced at the tip of the plant. Okay, that is growing your shoot tip and root tip. He has done an experiment in Avena polyptera. Avena means oats plant. Avena means oats plant. He has done the experiment in an Avena plant the coleoptile. Coleoptile means the shoot tip. Shoot tip of this plant is said to be coleoptile. So what the first experiment he has, what he has done is he has removed the growing tip of the coleoptile. Once again, listen carefully. So what the first experiment, what he has done is he has removed the growing, that is coleoptile, he has removed the tip of the growing tip, shoot tip he has removed. Okay, then what happened to the plant? The plant is not able to grow. First plant, it is not able to grow. Then the next experiment, what he has done is he has removed the tip of the, he has again removed the tip and he kept a upper block above the tip region. Okay, in the tip region he has removed, tip region he has removed and kept an upper block over there. So what happened to the plant? The plant again it is not able to grow. Then the next experiment is to first experiment, second experiment. So first both the experiment, the plant is after removing the tip region, the plant is not able to grow even if after keeping the upper block. Okay, so these are the first two experiments. The third experiment, what he has done is he has again removed the tip and he placed the cut tip. So he has cut the tip and kept it above the agar block. He kept it above the agar block. Then after 1 or 2 hours, what he has done? He has again removed the shoot tip from the agar block and he kept the agar block above the shoot tip. So what he has noticed is plant has started to grow. Okay, the third experiment, after keeping the agar block which has received something, it has received something from the tip region which has kept above the agar. Okay, the agar block has received some chemical substances, has obtained from some chemical substances from the tip region and he concluded that the growth hormone is present at the tip of the plants, that is and that hormone, the chemical substance is transferred, is said to be auxin, that is transferred to the substance is transferred to the agar block, and this agar block is having some chemical substances and it is responsible for the growth of the coleoptile. So he has concluded that the substance that is responsible for the growth of the plant is said to be auxin. So this is his experiment, Wendt experiment for proving that auxin is responsible for the growth of the plant. The next we are going to study about the physiological effects of auxin. What are the physiological? Once again, if you want, I'll explain it once again. Those are not understand, just listen once again. So he has before, that is auxin. F.W. Wendt was the person who has conducted an experiment. That is, auxin is responsible for the growth of the plants. Okay, so it is present at the tip region of the plant. So first, he has conducted the experiment in Avena plant, Avena coleoptile plant, and in this plant, he has selected for the first experiment, he had cut the root, that is, shoot tip, coleoptile tip, tip from the growing plant, and what happened? The plant is not, after that, he has cut down, the plant is not able to grow. The next experiment, what he has done, so he kept on agar block, he removed the tip and he kept on agar block above the growing tip. So again, in the second experiment also, the plant is not able to grow. The third experiment, what he has done, he has kept the agar, that is, cut tip over the agar block for 1 or 2 hours separately, it is kept in above the agar block for 1 or 2 hours. And he kept the agar block, only the agar block above the cut region. So after some time he has noticed that the plant is able to grow. So from this experiment he has concluded that some substance has been passed from the tip region to the agar block and that is responsible for the growth of the plant. Okay, so he has concluded that some substance, that is auxin, is present at the tip of the plant, that is root tip and shoot tip, and that is responsible for the that is longitudinal growth of the plants. So this is about the experiment. Next, we are going to study about the physiological effect. What are the physiological effects of auxin in plant? So before that, auxin it is of two types. Okay, auxin it is of two types. Natural auxin and synthetic auxin. Natural auxin and synthetic auxin. Natural auxin means it is naturally produced by the plants. It is not produced by the plant itself. That is said to be natural auxin. Example IAA, indole acetic acid. What is the full form? Indole acetic acid. Indole acetic acid is an example for natural auxin. Next one, synthetic auxin. This is also, this is artificially prepared auxin which is inducing the growth of the plant. Artificially prepared auxin which performs the function of auxin. Okay, artificially made auxin. Artificially prepared auxins are said to be synthetic auxin. Example 2,4-D. 2,4-D, that is 2,4-dichloro. Phenoxy acetic acid. Okay, that is so that is 2,4-D. Okay, it will form dichlorophenoxy acetic acid. These are all, these are the types of auxins. So these are two types, natural and synthetic auxins. Natural, it is naturally it is produced by the plant itself. That is said to be natural auxin. Example IAA, indole acetic acid. Second one, synthetic auxins, that is produced, artificially produced and introduced, that is performing the function of auxin. Example 2,4-D, 2,4-dichlorophenoxy acetic acid. Next one, we are going to study about the physiological effects. Okay. Auxin in plants. First one, it is a capable, it is a stem elongation. It gets, if it, auxins are responsible for the elongation of the stem. First point, elongation of the stem is performed by the presence of auxin. That is, longitudinal growth of the plants is carried out by the presence of auxin, elongation of stem. Then second one is root form, that is root formation, helps in induce root formation in the plants. Okay, second point, induce root formation. Induces root formation. Second point. Third one, it helps in, that is production of parthenopathic fruit. Parthenopathic fruits. What are parthenopathic fruits? That is seedless fruits. Seedless fruits are produced nowadays, and it is induced by the function of auxin. So, okay. Example, banana, grapes, tomato, etc. Grapes, tomato, and watermelon, etc. The next one, it induces apical dominance. Apical dominance means the apical dominance, that is, it will not allow the growth of lateral buds, the buds which is present at the sideways. The lateral buds formation is inhibited by the presence of what is the apical growth takes place. Okay, so this is a, so this is a plant. So this is a plant. This is the apex of the plant, and the buds which are arising from the nodal region of the leaves are said to be lateral buds. Okay, this are said to be lateral buds. Since the plant, the auxins are present at the tip of the plants, only the apical growth of the plants will be primary, and that will not allow the growth of this lateral buds. Okay, the apical dominance happens because of the presence of auxins. And last one, prevent abscission layer formation. Okay, it will prevent the formation of abscission layer. What is abscission? Abscission means the falling of leaf, fruits, aging of fruits, leaves, etc. That is known as abscission, and it forms the abscission layer. After the falling of leaf, it forms a layer known as abscission layer, and this auxins prevent the formation of abscission layer. So these are the different functions of the physiological effect of auxins on plants. First one, elongation of stem. It helps in the longitudinal growth of the plant takes place with, by the presence of auxin, stem elongation. The next one, induced root formation. Root formation takes place in the plants. The next one, parthenocarpic fruits, grapes, tomato, watermelon, etc. That's a seedless fruit. Seedless fruits are formed in this plants with the help of auxin. The next one, apical dominance. Here the apical bud suppresses the growth of lateral buds. So these are the lateral buds which are arising from the nodal region, and this apical bud will suppress the growth of lateral buds. That's the next function. Next one, prevent abscission layer formation. Formation of abscission, falling of, aging of plants, leaves, leaves, flowers, etc. is known as abscission, and this will, this auxins will prevent this abscission. So this is about the physiological effects. So next one, we are going to study about cytokinins. Where is it present? So it is the hormone which is responsible for the cell division. Okay, cell division of a plant. So it is said to be cyto means cell. Okay, it helps in cell division. Helps in cell division. Then where is it present? It is first it was found out from herring, fish, sperm. Herring, fish, sperm, they have found out the first cytokine, and creatine is the cytokine which is present in Siamese. Creatine is the cytokine which is present in Siamese. Okay, Siamese, maize plant. The cytokine is abundant, found more abundant in the liquid endosperm of coconut. Coconut water, you know, that is liquid endosperm of that coconut. And it is liquid endosperm is full of, is having cytokine. Okay, liquid endosperm. Liquid endosperm consists of more amount of cytokine. So this is about cytokine. It is a hormone which helps in cell division. Okay, the first one, it helps in cell division. Then it is first found out in herring, fish, sperm. Okay, then creatine is the cytokine. It is a type of cytokine which is present in the Siamese or maize. The next one, liquid endosperm of coconut. Liquid endosperm of coconut consists of more amount of cytokine. So this is about the nature of cytokine, where is it present. And next we are going to study about the physiological effects. What are the physiological effects of cytokine? So already I told that it is useful in cell division. It helps in cell division. First function, it promotes cell division in plants. Then second one, it promotes cell elongation. Cell elongation. Cell elongation. The next one, it helps in the formation of organs, plant organs from the callus during the tissue culture. Callus means you can say group of tissue. Okay, that is known as callus, and it is formed during the time of tissue culture. During the tissue culture, they are using this callus. That is group of cells, and this callus is developed into a single plant. So during this tissue culture, they are introducing this cytokinin, which will be able to produce, helping the callus to form the plant organs. Plant organs, and this process is known as morphogenesis. Morphogenesis. So, what is that? That is made self plant organ formation. It is during the time of tissue culture. Okay, callus is a group of tissue which is taken up from a plant, and it is used for producing a new plant. Okay, so this plant organs, the callus, from the callus, plant organs such as leaves, stem, root, etc. will arise, and that is taking place with the help of this cytokine. That process is known as morphogenesis. The next one, lateral bud formation. It induces lateral bud formation. Lateral bud. So first one we have studied about the apical dominance. Since it is apical dominance is performed by auxins. Here the lateral buds are performed. Growth of the lateral buds is induced by the presence of cytokine. Lateral bud growth takes place by the presence of cytokine. The next one, aging of plants. Aging of plants is prevented by this cytokine. Aging of plants. Aging of plants is controlled by the cytokine, and this is not, that is not allow the plants to get aged. Okay, so it is known as Richmond Bland effect. Richmond Bland effect. Okay, so these are the different function, physiological functions of cytokinin. Once again, listen, cytokinin, it is a hormone which is responsible for the cell division. That it is present in the that is fish sperm. Okay, herring, fish sperm. That it is in creatinine is the hormone cytokinin which is present in Siamese. The next one, endosperm. This cytokinin is more present more in endosperm of coconut, liquid endosperm of coconut. So this is about the occurrence. The next one, physiological effect. It promotes cell division. Helps in the cell division of the plants. The next one, cell elongation. Helps in cell elongation. The next one, plant organs during the time of morphogenesis. That is callus plant tissue culture. Morphogenesis takes place. Plant formation of plant organs takes place by the help of cytokines. The next one, lateral bud formation is induced by the cytokine. That is, apical dominance is controlled, and the lateral buds will be growing by the presence of cytokines. The next one, aging of plants. Aging of plants is controlled or prevented by this presence of cytokine. Then it is known as Richmond-Lang effect. Richmond-Lang effect, which means the aging of plant is controlled. Okay, that is by the presence of this cytokinin hormone. So this is about the function, physiological effects of hormones, cytokinin hormones in plants. Next one, gibberellins. Gibberellins, these are also plant hormones. This is a plant in, promoter. Okay, this is also an example for plant growth promoter. So it is found on, it is found in fool. It is a foolish seedling disease. Okay, it is first found out by Japanese. Foolish seedling disease, which causes the, which is caused by a fungi known as Gibberella frugivora. Gibberella frugivora, and this Gibberella fulgicora consists of this hormone. So this hormone gibberellin is extracted from this fungus called Gibberella fulgicora. So it is found, when it is first found out by Japanese, they are noticed that this is called Gibberella, that is foolish seedling disease. Foolish seedling disease, that is in paddy plant, it causes the elongation, that is internodal elongation takes place in the paddy plant. So there is no internode formation in paddy. So the plant was affected by Gibberella fulgicora, a fungi, and this is responsible for the production of gibberellin, and which causes the elongation of the stem in paddy plant. So this is about the occurrence of gibberellin. Okay, so once again, this is first found in paddy plant, and it is called foolish seedling disease. Okay, foolish seedling disease, and this seedlings consist of, that is, shows internodal elongation. Paddy plant shows internodal elongation. That is because of the presence of this fungus, the Gibberella fulgicora, which is responsible for the production of gibberellin, and this gibberellin causes the internodal elongation in that plant. Okay, so this is about the first, they have how the occurrence has started. Okay, they have found out the gibberellin. Next one, physiological effect we are going to study. First one, it causes the internodal elongation. Application of this gibberellin causes internodal elongation. Physiological effects of gibberellin. First one, internodal effects in elongation of internodes or internodal elongation. Internodal elongation helps in the elongation of internodes. The next one, there is bolting. It helps in bolting. What is bolting? The sudden elongation of the internodes, that is followed by flowering of the plant, that is known as bolting. Okay, that is in rosette plants. Rosette plants means that is growing crowdly. Okay, that is said to be crowded. The leaves will be crowded at the stem region, and it does not consist of nodes, and internodes will not be there. So for that purpose, the bolting takes place. The gibberellin induces bolting, that is sudden internodal elongation takes place in the plant, and it results in the formation of flowers, which is followed by flowering. Okay, that is said to be bolting. Internodal elongation of internodes, which is followed by flowering. Okay, that process is known as bolting. Okay, so these are the first two functions. Next one, induce the formation of male flowers in monoecious plants. Okay, monoecious plants means male flowers. Formation of male flowers in monoecious plants. Example, cucumber. Okay. Cucurbits. Here, monoecious, what is monoecious plant? Both male and female flowers are separate. Okay, not in the same flower, the both male and female and male flowers are separate. That is sex organs. Ambition will be present in one flower and gynoecium will be present in another flower. Female and male flowers will be produced by the same plant. That is said to be monoecious plants. Here, by applying gibberellins, we can induce the formation of male flowers. Okay. Example, cucurbits. Cucurbits means it will include cucumber, watermelon, etc. will be included under the cucurbits, and the male flower formation is induced in this plant by using this gibberellins. The next one, dormancy. Potato tuber. Break dormancy in a break dormancy in potato tuber. What is dormancy? It is some plants during the growing time, some for some season or some for a month or two or a month, it will be taking rust. Okay, then the rusting stage is said to be dormancy. Without growth, the plant will be all the functions will be going on, but the plant will not be able to not be growing. Okay, that stage is said to be dormancy. This gibberellins helps to break dormancy in potato tuber. Potato tuber, you know, it consists of small eyes. From that eyes only the new plants are arising. So this break the dormancy in potato tuber. So this is the third point. Then last point. Parthenocarpy. This also induces the formation of parthenocarpic fruit. Okay. Parthenocarpic fruit. So these are the different functions of that is physiological effect of gibberellin. First one, it helps in internodal elongation. It will stimulate the internodal elongation in plants. The next one, bolting. What is bolting? Sudden elongation of the stem in the nodes. And finally, there is in rosette plants. In rosette plants, it is able to produce stem elongation. That is by the elongation of internodes, and it is followed by flowering. That process is known as bolting. Okay, rosette plants means that is growing crowded. Okay, without nodes, the plants will be leaves will be crowded in the region. Since such plants, it is able to produce the internodes, and it will be resulting in the formation of flowers. That process is said to be bolting. The next one, in monoecious plants, the male flowers are induce the production of male flowers in monoecious plant. Example, cucurbit. The next one, it breaks the dormancy in potato tuber. In potato tuber, it is resting stage. In some cases, the potato tuber will remain the resting stage, so that the plant will not be able to grow at that time. And this is broken down by the help of this gibberellins. The next one, partheno. It induces the formation of parthenocarpic fruit. Seedless fruits are produced in tomato, watermelon, banana, etc., grapes, etc. You are able to produce the seedless fruit, parthenocarpic fruits, by inducing gibberellins. That's all functions of this gibberellins. Okay. The next one, abscisic acid. This is an example for gibberellin. It is growth promoter. This is growth inhibitor. Okay, this is an example for growth inhibitor. Growth inhibitor. That is, it will inhibit the growth of the plant, or it will stop or delay the process of growth of the plant. That is said to be abscisic acid. Okay, that is. Growth inhibitor. Example for growth inhibitor. Then it helps the plant to overcome the various kinds of stress the plant is plants will be having some stress condition during the drought condition or during flood condition. The plant will be having some stress. Okay, that is, this abscisic acid will be able to help the plant to overcome the stress situation. Okay. Overcome the stress situation, and so it is said to be stress hormone. Stress hormone in plants. Okay, this is about abscisic acid. Then it is present in the chloroplast. Okay, it is present in the chloroplast of plants. Present in the chloroplast of plants. So this is about the occurrence of the abscisic acid. So abscisic acid is an example for growth inhibitor. It is present in the chloroplast. It helps the plant to overcome the stress situation. So it is also known as stress hormone. The next one, coming to the physiological effects. Physiological effects. It will be able to, the plants will be able to overcome the climatic conditions. Okay, during frost, etc., the plant will be overcome the
climatic conditions. Okay, first one, climatic condition. Next one, it will break the, that is during the kept in the breaking the dormancy of the seed. Breaking dormancy, and there is inhibitor. It is an inhibitor of the growth. Okay, it inhibits the growth of the plants. So these are the different physiological effects of abscisic acid. It climate overcome the plants during the climatic condition that break the dormancy of the buds. The next inhibits the growth of the plant. These are the physiological effects of abscisic acid. The next one, last one, we are going to study about ethylene. This is the gaseous plant hormone. Gaseous plant hormone, and this is produced during the ripening of the fruits. The gaseous plant hormone. This is produced during ripening of fruits. Okay. Ripening of fruits. This is about the occurrence. This is the only the gaseous plant hormone which is present in plants of ethylene, and it is produced during mostly produced abundantly during the ripening of the seeds. Then what are the physiological effects of ethylene? It inhibits the elongation of the stem. First one, it inhibits the elongation of stem. Inhibits stem elongation. That hastens the senescence. It will fosters the senescence of leaves, fruits, etc. Senescence of leaves, fruits, etc. That is falling of leaves, fruits, flowers, etc. is caused by the presence of ethylene. Then finally, it breaks the dormancy. It also helps in breaking dormancy. So these are the some of the physiological effects. First one, it inhibits the stem elongation. It inhibits the stem elongation in plants. Then fastens the senescence. That is falling of leaves, fruits, etc. is caused by the the next one, it breaks the dormancy of the plants. Okay, these are some of the physiological effects of ethylene. So ethylene is a gaseous plant hormone. It is produced during the ripening of fruits. The functions, we have inhibits stem elongation, hastens the senescence, and also break the dormancy. So this is about the plant hormone. So we have studied about 5 different types of plant hormones. What are they? Auxins, cytokines, gibberellins, abscisic acid, and finally ethylene. So next class we can see about the animal hormones. Okay, thank you all.